Yeah, it looks like the people call for the champion, the Paladin. Feel like winning today, I guess.
I will serve.
Paladin. That's a good first card. That's not a good second card. Actually, Lights of Justice is pretty good. It's okay. Certainly better than the rest. Now I have two Lights Justices in my deck. Holy Wrath. That's probably better than the other cards. Yep. Even though it's bad. Well, this is still a fair cost for Muster for Battle. If I got the choice to pick Muster for Battle and then get dealt like two subpar cards afterwards, I think I would be willing to take that trade. Good trade. Blackwater Pirate is actually too. Okay. But I'll take Holy Wrath. That's a four. Bound to be okay, three. Now this is okay. Puddle Stomper. Fine. Best of Torn, I guess. Over another Light's Justice, yeah. Flame Juggler, solid. Refreshment Vendor, I guess. Hey, there we go. Shielded Mini Bot. Corrupted Seer, I guess. I mean, that's actually good. Surprisingly. Berserker. Decent card. Oh, these three cards are all quite good. Think it just depends on which flavor I need. So, five drop, I have none. Two drop, I have three of them, which is a lot already. Even though this is one of my favorite two drops in Paladin because of the Inspire. Abusive Sergeant. You have Muster for Battle to hit with the Abusive. I have a mini bot. So I think on a neutral playing field, I think Boneguard Lieutenant is the best card here. But due to my curve, I think it's the worst card here. That's a close one between Tiger and Abusive Sergeant. All three of these cards are really close. I have Holy Wrath, which inclines me slightly towards the Tiger. Guys are good with Abusive Sergeant, though. That's a tough one. I go Abusive. Really tough pick. Harvest Golem. Looted Hoarder. Consecration. Another mini bot. End Creeper. It's a five. I think it beats the Toasting Worgen. Yeah. Twisted Worgen. Yeah, I have enough twos. And I have no fives. A Warhorse Trainer, I guess. Combos with Muster for Battle, but more importantly, the stats are decent. The other two. Looks like I'm gonna lose a lot of jousts with this deck. A Light in the Darkness. Alright. I don't need another two drop, I need something that can get something late game. Or flexible. Oh, this pick's bad. Ensign Coach is not terrible? 3-mana 2/2, summon a 1/1. Midnight Drake. 5/4. We'll Blind Oracle. It's a 3-mana 2/2. Drake, I guess. Sector. Hard draw to keep going. The Brute's good. Horse Rider's good. I've got enough twos, yeah. Good enough. For now. Shattered Sun's good. Although, Bog Creeper. That's also actually probably the pick. I have no sevens. I have a decent amount of threes. Though the Cleric is nice with my early game setup. I got the Creeper. Kings. Pretty good. Eldritch Horror. I think I am actually going to pick it. My 8-drop. Dr. 8. Kind of. And another Kings. Cool. Or Spider Tank. Another Kings. I've got like a lot of sticky things. Oh, True Silver. I thought that was my last pick. I actually have two more. Well, that's a good card. And Twilight Drake over Midnight Drake. No Death Lord, right? No Death Lord. This deck has some really good cards and some, and like quite a few average cards in it. So it picked up too many bots, Muster for Battle, two Kings when I have a lot of like stickiness, like Muster for Battle, mini bot, and Harvest Golem. Consecration. And it's got like a middling of big cards at the end. This Light in the Darkness could actually prove to be the light that shines through at the end. There's my Tyrion right there. So yeah, it certainly could have been a better Paladin Arena, but it's solid enough. I think it's solid enough to give it a guess of 9. That is how much I respect the Paladin class. Because don't forget, you can always push the button in Paladin. Let's see, in the early game I've got too many bot, Puddle Stomper, Flame Juggler. That's actually a surprisingly small amount of early game. I just had so much early game in the beginning. I'm going to guess 8. Sometimes I'm going to not get one of those cards and then I'll have a bad time. And I just happen to like have a whole host of mediocre fours. Like, we have mediocrity in this deck. There's Horror, there's Holy Wrath, which is good with Horror. There's a Bender, I guess, Midnight Drake, Polluted Hoarder, Aberrant Berserkers, like not that great, Warhorse Trainer, Blessing of Wisdom, Light's Justice. These are all cards that aren't great. They're kind of like okay. I'd say the big flaw in this deck is actually too many fours and not enough twos. Didn't I at some point pick a four over a two because I had too many? No, I picked a one over a two. I picked Abusive Sergeant over a some kind of two drop, which I thought was decent. Oh, Bone Guard Lieutenant. I would have rather had the Bone Guard Lieutenant here, but who knew that I wouldn't get enough twos afterwards. So, here we go. Nope, almost forgot to put the deck list. Import from Arena? Ah, thanks, deck track. The name of this game is going to be quite simple. Can I get a 2-drop? Or can I have a coin with a 3-drop? Which is a lot easier. Let's Justice. We'll bop a few of her Paladin recruits. Okay, that's a monstrously good hand. Monstrous. This weapon is so good, I'm not even going to send it at her face. I only have 3 weapons. Oh, look at this value that this weapon is going to get. Oh, muster for battle. But yeah, this one's actually better than Minibot because it's up against the 1-1. So I'm actually encouraged not to play muster for battle so I can get more value out of Light's Justice first. It's like, oh, muster for battle. Actually, muster for battle in this turn is quite solid since he's got a rallying. Which does kill the Harvest Golem perfectly, but doesn't kill the muster, and also doesn't kill the Twilight Drake. Muster on turn 3, I guess.
Trogzor.
Let's see, I'll start hitting this thing. It might seem pointless, but that one damage can matter. Like, maybe I send all 3 of these guys in, do 1 more damage. For example, or a Flame Juggler does 1, and when Silverhand Recruit gets in there. Or he just inexplicably trades into that. No, not inexplicable, it's a trade. Oh.
The battle! The battle for justice! The battle!
Small weapons are interesting. It's like, if you can hit something with it, you probably... There's a good chance you should, even if you can't do anything with it immediately. There's a decent chance. Good enough chance. Queen Block Creeper, probably.
Reporting for duty.
We could get into my guy summoning phase.
Toasty.
I don't want to put out that when he hasn't played any removal yet. This is a good card against that, but it's a really bad card against Consecration. It's a good card against Consecration. Let's play. Okay. Like, play around Consecration, play around, Keeper of Uldumon. One's a rare, one's a common.
Should I? Should I?
I still haven't unlocked my Liadrin. Random thought.
None may steal us.
Wait, Keeper of Uldumon is not a rare. What? It's been a while since I played Arena, I guess. What was I thinking? Why is this not a rare?
Toasty.
Must have been in a dream. Guy or mini bot? I'm gonna go Guy.
Reporting for duty.
Since I'm running out of stuff. The next turn I'll probably go Tauren mini bot Guy. Tauren's pretty bad against his cards. 3-5 looks to be pretty decent. Actually, I'm not even gonna make a guy this turn. Looks like I need to play it a little bit faster. I drew a card that draws a card. Fine card to play.
Not on my watch.
Uh-oh. Are we gonna see a comeback? My ex? Nah. A little bit scary. I could put Blessing of Wisdom on my ex, nah.
Let me think.
No, better to put the cards in my own cards since I'm about to attack with one. And where should this attack? Here? Or face?
I wonder.
I think I should put. Probably face. And then I put the Divine Shield on this, and then these. You might have to attack it with that. And goes down a bit. Low. I have a bunch of stuff. Do I make a guy, or do I play mini bot? I'm running out of cards, I should probably make a guy. Alright, close call. The guy just dies to the 2-2, or the 1-2, but that 2-2 kind of needs to go somewhere else, too. Didn't expect it to go there. So me hitting his face made him play more passive.
Well met.
Uh-oh. Quite a board.
Reporting for duty. Reporting for duty.
Arr.
This is my responsibility.
Can win with a true silver champion still.
Shields up. Red alert.
Or a Holy Wrath. Corrupted Seer could be pretty good too. And if he attacks one of my guys with the weapon, Argent Horse Rider might do it. If any of my guys survive, Abusive Sergeant will do it. Uh-oh. How could he... Oh. Ah.
Well played.
Ah! Well, he was good on the board anyways against me, probably. That's I super had that. It came down to that key turn where I decided to play around Consecration instead of Keeper of Olden. It's like, but if I play it the other way, he consecrates me, and then I'm sad too.
Uther versus Uther.
Okay, we'll come back from that loss.
I will command the light.
Loss of sadness. I think I get rid of this 3-drop, even though it's a good one, because I have other good 3-drops in the deck. And I want to go for a 2-drop. Nope, got the good 3-drop. Shell-shocked. How do I lose? I played Muster for Battle on turn 3 and I lost. Unbelievable. Yeah, warm-up game.
Reporting for duty.
It's fine. Light in the darkness or guy. Light in the darkness. I'm gonna smash that guy with the muster anyways. So, 3-drop, 4-drop, 5-drop? 6-drop maybe?
For justice.
Reporting for duty.
Locked and loaded.
Midnight Drake is gonna be a 6/4. That's decent.
The battle for justice.
It's just like Ancient Shade. Similar to Ancient Shade. Similarly destroyed. I think I attack with this weapon. Nah, I was thinking I would probably play a True Silver, but it's not certain that I'll play True Silver. In fact, it's pretty unlikely I'll play True Silver given all the costs. Cards cost 5.
Follow the rules.
That's a slight problem. Not a problem yet, but eventually a problem.
For the Empress.
For justice.
Corrupted Seer was actually a decent play there. Attack that, play Corrupted Seer, play that, but I can Corrupted Seer later. It's not a problem while I've got these big cards in my hand. An Abusive Sergeant for 5 mana is actually looking pretty good. It's like Bane of Doom. Impressive. I'll play a True Silver though.
For justice. Reporting for duty.
Interesting. He knows I can play exactly one card. Unless he kills that off. Or unless he plays a guy that I can kill my guy off. I looked at that Abusive Sergeant and I was like, 5 mana, deal 2 damage, get a 2-1. That's just like Bane of Doom. Oh, I love the button so much, though. I mean, their button was pretty justified. I either play it or I charge a 2-1 into his face, or I play a 2-4. 1-1. Good enough. Versus a 2-4. Reporting for duty. Wow, one of the spawns of the Zoss is guaranteed to go off. Brilliant.
Don't worry, loves. The cavalry's here. Giddy up! For justice, the battle!
It's clobbering!
Reporting for duty.
My ancestors watch over me.
I guess he saved his bad cards for the end. That's weird. I mean, I could play the Corrupted Seer, but I can just kill everything old school style.
The battle! The battle! Funnel cakes! Get your funnel cakes here! Reporting for duty.
Oh, wow. I almost made a misplay. Corrupted Seer against the Grimskull Oracle.
Reporting for duty. Mount up!
You never play against decks this bad? Well, I mean, I guess you're really good then. It means you never lose the first game. That's incredible. Unless you're lying, or you haven't played enough Arena.
Me smash you!
The battle!
I hit it with this thing versus this thing because of the 3 equals 2 philosophy against the Paladins. Impressive. Alright. Ogre Brute! Aim true! Wow. That wasn't even the discovered card. Really impressive how he managed to construct that deck. I would have thought it was a pick the worst cards draft if it weren't for some of the good cards in there.
Versus Anduin!
The light shall bring victory.
I will fight with honor.
I don't think that's a 2-drop. I mean, it's 2, but... This is solid 3 and 4. But there are other 3-drops that are good. But this is the best one against early game cards, and it's a priest, they can't deal more. Interesting. So I played the Light's Justice on turn one. Probably, yes. Which means I will not play that on 4, most likely.
Reporting for duty.
That's a very slow start by the first. Alright.
Mount up to battle!
It's just that one damage to him just doesn't matter, and it's more likely that I use this thing 4 entire times. The chance that that happens over me, like, doing one extra damage to him, I weigh it, like, I'm so patient with Light's Justice.
My echo.
Oh look, there's a excellent use for Light's Justice.
For justice!
I'm tempted to put the Busting Wisdom on this while it looks like he can't deal with it, and I have a bunch of taunts to put behind it. This is a really slow tempo move. Blessing of Wisdom guy. That would be ridiculous. I have so many cards, what am I thinking? I could actually do Infested Taurian Coin, Blessing of Wisdom, that would be very reasonable. Yeah, let's see what happens. The addiction! Alright, I have enough cards, I'm gonna press the button. Someone help me, I need an intervention. This button.
Charge! For justice.
Yeah, it's late enough in the game. I'm willing to use one of my precious charges of Light's Justice on his face. We'll allow it.
Charge!
Wow. I've drawn enough cards, I don't actually need to protect this with my
justice.
Fonts. And Paladin is a success. Look at that, I managed to use all the charges of Light's Justice. If only I hit in his face that one time, then I'd have one more charge to play around with. Oh look, more Light's Justice. Guess I can hit him really hard, though. Pretty tempting.
Let me think.
I'll play this card first. If it hits either of those, I can get an easy trade. And then not commit to the all-face strat. And I was gonna play this and this. Alright. Play this. Unless I want to make a guy. Wait, actually. Different plan. No, I have to... I should hit him with everything. I should make a guy. It makes lethal more likely. It's 8-4. This is gonna get 4-3 anyways. Okay. It probably means I shouldn't have... Well, no, that's okay. Hit him for lethal even if he heals, unless he has taunt, which would be cheating. Almost.
Get in there and fight, maggot! Don't worry, love.
For
the cavalry's here.
Kind of close. I was scared. If he had played a taunt there or healed himself, it's possible he would have been out of range for him. Possible.
Fight with honor.
Well, I continue my streak of getting an early game card. Yes. That's a pretty good hand. Juggler. Ace no matter what? Yeah. Fine. Interesting. Hit that one instead. Possibly because of mech synergy?
For justice.
Some sort. Well, I'm keeping up the aggressive drive, and I have the champion and less clear of a curve, so champion is probably gonna go down. Means I'm going to attack it though. Fights justice here. For justice.
The battle! For justice!
See, it's different this game than last game. Because here I don't have an obvious curve to follow. This is a stark difference from the last game indeed.
Don't worry, loves. The cavalry's here.
The battle! The battle!
Giddy up!
For justice!
That was very ambitious by him. I realized he killed a 1-1 in semi-4-2. I mean, he gets a better trade there, but... soon he will be deceased. Five, three, two, one.
The battle of justice.
Fitting that I killed him with the last card of White's justice.
I will fight with honor. I will come out.
That's a good hand. Pretty good. Where's my muster for battle, though? He'll probably draw into a 3.
Duty.
A good card. Ooh, and curve. Good. I mean, I predicted this would go 8 wins, but I've been having exceptionally good early game draws. It's almost, there's a consideration of playing Festator in case he has True Silver Champion. This is too powerful a play to resist, probably.
None may steal our secrets.
I'll go with the champion here. Soft curve though, but Holy Wrath has a chance for disaster. Has a chance of being really good.
For justice!
One day, I'll be a real knight.
For justice.
You get to kill a 5-drop for free. It's nice.
Run away!
Reporting for duty.
3, 5, 6. Darn, I drew Bog Creeper. That could have been 7 damage. I have the Eldritch Heart in my hand. I'll just play this instead of risk it. Okay. So the most I can get is 6, which probably means I should aim it at the 6-6. Bow! It's still good!
Get in there and fight, man.
This card's so good that I am willing to take the 1. Yes, light in the darkness. I probably should flame juggle this.
It's getting hot in here.
Huh. Wait, the math doesn't work out in my favor at all here. Oh, it just means I
must move quickly.
It actually, it didn't matter. So I should have made a guy. I'm gonna end up. Wait, no, it doesn't matter. I just didn't think about doing that one for some reason. Okay, we're good. Ten six, how? Bro, it's over 10, 12, 14, 16 to the face.
I'm
gonna control this stuff. Due to 10-6, 10-4. Spread it out. 6-5, hit, 6-3, 2, now. At 4-7-2. Wow, a heal for 12.
Not on my watch.
Wow, I actually valued 4 health over a 1-1 there. I guess I more valued having real estate to summon guys. I guess I played around AoE a little bit by gaining 4 health by not using my weapon.
My eyes are open.
Depart, foul creature.
Okay, I know you guys have been eagerly awaiting to find out what is in a light in the darkness, and I think this turn we will finally find out. What's in the box? Holy cow, that's a good box. Alright, I'll take that one.
This
This is my responsibility.
To battle!
For justice!
My fire be burned! Flesh fail!
Victory.
Ta-da.
Versus Jaina!
You asked for it.
I will fight with honor.
Any bot muster? Almost? Not quite. At least I have the button. True Silver. I just don't care about hitting him in the face for one. It's entirely possible I play Blessing of Kings on 4 instead of True Silver. This beats the Argent Horse Rider.
The battle for justice.
I need this Light's Justice to smash all the spiders. I think, in general, hitting the face with Light's Justice is wrong unless you have a good reason to. The next turn I'll probably play Holy Wrath instead of True Silver, so I should not hit the face. Or I could play like a 3 and a 2, that's more realistic. I might need all these charges of Light's Justice! Look at these beautiful charges of Light's Justice that someone else might just throw away. One damn one. It doesn't actually contest the 6/4. Yeah, let's hit that thing. Yeah. Fantastic. Like his minions have taunt for my Light's Justice. No, who's gonna push that button? What have you done?
Hello, hello.
I need all the charges of Light's Justice, don't you see? Do you not see now? They're all essential. Yeah.
for justice.
And play Horse Rider and Pillow Stomper. And then the question is which one of these attacks that? Probably this thing. Yeah, then it can possibly stay alive. Yeah.
Don't worry, Lux. The cavalry team.
And look, I have one last charge of Light's Justice for Bog Creeper next turn. Perfectly planned with Light's Justice. Although I should not use the last charge of Light's Justice, because I'm not guaranteed to need to play True Silver Champion next turn. I'll probably go Harvest Golem Holy Wrath.
Two heroes enter, one hero leaves.
Wapow! Perfect.
I'm not lonely anymore.
Or no, my God. Someday I'll be just like you.
Man, if I had an Azoth in this deck. Alright, Light in the Darkness. And then 4 drop and then Hero Power. Yeah, that one. Actually, maybe True Silver to clear the board. No, no need to clear the board. He didn't have an answer to this. I don't even have to use the last charge of Light's Justice, since I need to play Nyxia next turn. I should stick it around, since this 4 plus 1 can go 5. Light's Justice must stay. Oh no! My board is clear! Oh no! I'm just kidding.
For the crusade!
Silvermoon shall not fall.
Alright, so that goes in there. For the board at the whelps. Well enough that I don't really want to use that. So I'm gonna do 2, 6, 10. Game's ending soon enough that I don't need to press the button.
Let me think.
Should go there since I don't need the juggler damage. Oops, troll last, whatever. That one. This one.
Justice.
Alright. Justice.
I am ready.
Oh, where's my one damage Light's Justice now?
For justice.
Give me a minute.
You win this one.
Let's see, thank you for subbing, GMBA Manager, and El Pimpador and Skip Arena. Let me get to Geomichi's awesome donation right after. 1420, yo.
Uther versus Thrall!
For Doomhammer,
I will fight with honor.
It's more musters and shielded mini bots. I guess that'll do. Do I coin out juggler though? Yes. Or this one.
It's getting hot in here.
Unintentional corrupted seer. Puddle Stomper synergy. I should try for this. Pretty big 50-50 here. Got him. This goes face regardless, right? Yeah, because. Okay. Yay! Six, 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 seven. Does one equal two? Yeah, one equals two. But three equals two also. Huh. Dilemmas. I probably should have done the 2-2. When I look at the board, I'd rather have a 6-1 and a 2-3 than a 6-2 and a 2-2, but it's kind of a small difference. He would have lightning bolted my 3-1 as well, possibly. So I'd have a 2-3 instead of a 2-2 here, but it doesn't seem to matter much. It's not time to press the button yet. It is too soon to press the button.
Weapon ready.
Ogre too scared to attack in a 7-7 here. That would be awful if it did. Am I willing to miss 4 damage? Yes, because this is a board control deck.
Weapon ready.
Pessimistic view. Or safe play, in other words. I considered attacking while there were three minions out too, because if it hit the 3-1, it wasn't that bad. But I just decided not to. I also think it's wrong to put Blessing of Wisdom on his card, because at most he attacks twice with it. Whereas if I put it on my guy, it's guaranteed to attack once, and maybe it attacks twice or even three times. Interesting. You hit it over the ogre. Huh. That's some BM towards ogres right there. There's a 75% chance that I do not hit the 7-7. Yeah. Give it a shot, ogre. Uh-oh. Okay. Whew. I want to put it on the 1-1 because it would be really annoying for him to have to detour into a 1-1 with a 7-7. Okay, soon we will be able to take down this Titan, my small guys. We'll call it Attack on Titan.
What to do? What to do?
Little time.
Depart, foul creature.
Very manly move by him. But he's about to take 7? Pow! 4. That's pretty good. Yeah, okay.
Me smash you.
Looks like that 3 drop doesn't matter because what I need are odd numbers, and making the odd numbers even doesn't help.
Me smash
you. Hopefully,
you.
Glancing at this board, you can understand why.
Me smash you.
I know I speak kind of cryptically sometimes, but hopefully, here it's obvious. I think a button might be better than Warhorse Train. No, I don't play Warhorse Train.
The battle.
Maybe Light in the Darkness. Yeah, Warhorse Trainer still.
The battle.
Weapon ready.
Too slow to play that.
Smash you.
Definitely want to break that divine shield. I hate to do it with a 2-4, but good enough, I guess. It might be broken with the ogre brute. Maybe I should do this. Yeah. Okay. You go do that, ogre brute. Good job. I feel like a Light in the Darkness is too slow. I already have cards that I can play. I use 7 plus button, arguing that button is better than Light in the Darkness. Why? Because 6-8 plus 1-1 kills that. Although I guess he has a healing totem, so it didn't actually matter. Yeah, it's fine, I have this guy. Alright, ogre, will you attack one funnel target for me? Nice. You could actually have made a 5-3 instead of a 3-5. I think 3-5 is better. No, 5-3 is better.
Did you
no, 3-5 is better. The shamans deal 3 a lot. Yeah, let's find out what's in the box. That 1-3 Nerubian egg. Actually pretty good.
You win this one.
Yeah, setting lethal. It doesn't matter. He only has two cards in his hand. A pessimist would think that he would burst me on that turn. So I prevented that by healing myself. That's impossible with two cards, but.
Uther versus Jaina!
You asked for it.
I will fight with honor.
Ooh. The abusive sergeant is so good with muster for battle. I guess I'll keep it and not play it on turn one. Though playing it on turn one is like it's worth thinking about. I will not do it though. It would have prevented that play, but who knows. It would have done something different. Besides, on turn 4 I can press the button, play abusive, and play Blessing of Wisdom. Good. We're kings. They're both pretty good. The Knife Juggler is going to die eventually with muster for battles, lights, justice, anyways.
Mind if I roll knee?
Bad juggle. Expected one health. I've got a real choice. It depends on whether or not he plays a high attack, low, high attack, 3 health minion. That would be Blessing of Kings. Unless it's Warhorse Trainer. Warhorse Trainer, Abusive Sergeant. Wow. That's pretty good.
Mount up!
Get in there and fight, maggot!
The battle! The battle!
Thought about whether or not to use the Light's Justice for a moment. This is pretty aggressive, but I think I'll have enough time to decide whether or not to hit base with the Light's Justice still. I'll hit him this turn. Two choices. Mini bot guy? Mini bot guy, given that I have this Warhorse trainer up. Otherwise, I would have played Berserker.
Weapon ready.
For justice.
That's pretty good against my 2-1s. Ace it is then.
It's time for a lot of
the battle. The battle.
What you want?
Ah, that's lethal. 4, 6, 7, 8, 9 plus 7. 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 13. No, it's actually lethal. 4, 6. For justice, the last charge.
Malfurion.
I must protect the wild.
I will fight with honor.
Many old god creations there. Pretty spooky. Come on, Living Roots. Let me show you what justice is made of. Oh. 2-2, and then I somehow kill it with these two. Or 3-2. That'd be awesome. Oh man. Huge 50-50 here. If it survives, I have something to Argent Protector. Uh-oh. I'm willing to take 3 for the insurance. Like, he is of course going to do this, but if I didn't do that, he might not have done this. And then, like, wrath or something.
For justice.
And then we'll have to use this one.
Reporting for duty.
Missed 1 damage. Turn 1.
The battle. The battle. For justice. The battle.
Wait, I should have coin armor plating. Yes. No. It would have been -2 on Drake. And I wouldn't be able to protect her. I would probably end up playing Creeper, actually. I didn't even think about it, which was a problem. It's not right or wrong.
Justice,
Freak is still the same amount of health. I'll play it with the Argent Protector next turn, probably. I had to hit that in preparation for it getting plus one health. Wow. Defeated.
For justice.
You refuse to give up my guy. I would die for you.
Not on my watch.
It's all about board control after all. Without board control, it doesn't matter how low your health is. Any small advantage I can get. Coin saved for exactly that moment. Something, something.
Spectacular. By the holy light.
I can still use that last charge of Light's Justice. Look at it, it's so beautiful here. I'm going to want to armor plate that. Do I use the weapon? Or do I? Yes, I do. And then I go down to 4, but then I go up to 8. And then I can play this instead of that.
For justice.
It's better to play the 4/4 slow card than 2/1 just to save. Three health? Two health. Zombie chow. What's for dinner? I don't want this to hit face, so I'm even willing to have it hit the 3/3 even though I don't want it. 3/3. Okay.
Pay up.
See, that's how important board control is. He knows that he's doesn't have any chart, like any direct sources of damage left. So even though playing the zombie chow is terrible, if he doesn't play, he's gonna lose board control and never be able to do damage to me again. And so I don't think I hit Light's Justice, the second one, into the face the entire game. I used it for the board control. It's how important it is. Blood Imp.
Kill them all!
I could actually kill the Blood Imp if I wanted to.
Kill them all! Reporting for duty. Well played.
I'm one short of the lethal.
I can see.
But he had no way to ever do direct damage to me if I just kept board controlling him. Although that's a nah. I'm fine.
Versus Jaina.
You asked for it.
I will fight.
I've been drawing my early game a lot. I'm bound to have one game where I don't. And then, fine, I'll lose. But this is not that game. Still. This is still not that game. Yeah. This one beats the mini bot against the 1-3. But if he has like a flame cannon or a frost bolt, it's kind of bad. But what can you do? I guess he can play mini bot. But then it's still not good enough. Nice. It's a trade. Ooh. I think I go mini-bot guy over mini-bot light in the darkness, because I have a turn... we'll see.
Pay attention, class.
True silver.
For justice.
Weapon ready.
It's getting hot in here!
Wow. He definitely should have fire blast there. That's actually a blatant mistake.
Weapon ready.
For justice!
Blatant mistake at 8-1. It's justice is here to save. Wa-pow! What just happened? What just happened? Oh! Well, that's bad.
Pass me that arc light spanner.
Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. It doesn't look that scary now. Got 11 the next turn. That's pretty scary. Can I afford to play this card? Deals 11 to me, I'm at 9. Kill one of the things. Now, we're going for the special.
Time for
red alert.
Is this my light in the darkness? He's definitely encouraged to go face since that's so much damage, and the way that he can deal with my guys is kind of awkward. It is my light in the darkness.
Weapon ready.
It'd be a comeback. Stuff.
Get your final case here.
Report weapons ready.
And I hope he doesn't. Oh, well, I mean, I was hoping he didn't have burn. I like kind of counts. Just burn.
Well played. The victory is yours.
Things are going so well until he played everything somehow. How did he not? Things are going well until I Holy Wrath for one. Kind of. Yeah, that kind of sucks. Grumble, grumble. Ah.
With honor.
Muster for battle. That probably means I don't even play Light's Justice, since I'm pretty much going to play Muster for battle on turn 3. However, what I could do is play Light now. I'll go pretty hard with the first Light's Justice from Muster for Battle. I was thinking about playing Light's Justice and then attacking the 3-2 if you played one. I will go a Light in the Darkness here. Never mind. I wonder if I can get all 8 charges of Light's Justice to hit minions this game. Pretty unlikely. I think at least 4 charges of Light's Justice will hit minions this game, though. One. This is now the Light's Justice arena.
Can I light your fire?
Ouch.
It's getting hot in here.
For justice.
And the guy is much better tempo than the light in the darkness right here. Since if that 2-2 in the 1-1 fight, and I have light's justice. Yep. You know, I commented on this before, but
what to do?
Twilight Flamecaller into Muster for Battle, while bad for Muster for Battle, is almost an even trade. Because he gets a 2-2, but I get a 1-4 weapon. Which is disgusting. And I've said that before. Alright, 3. That should stay on curve. The Blessing of Kings makes a 5-1, which isn't good. I make a guy? Nah, I'm gonna play the mini butt. He'll have two things he wants to fire blast. The 2-1 as well as the mini bot. But the mini bot doesn't get fire blast. I have Blessing of Kings to buff it. And that's really good. To buff a bless. To buff something with Divine Shield and send it against something big.
Wanna blow something up?
Oh well. One of them was bound to be hit. Two choices, Drake guy or King's guy. King's is a 4-4 with charge, Drake is a slow 4-4. And can I could also light in the darkness instead of guy. I think I will do that. I don't have a good play the next turn. Okay. End creeper, maybe? The river would kill him really fast, but I need to be more defensive. I'm gonna die really fast. Oh, I made a 9-9 though. Yeah, I need this. They would both get removed, probably. Well, I mean, this is a big removal target right here first. I'm gonna save that last charge.
Reporting for duty.
That one damage is so insignificant. If I end up drawing like a 7 or 8 drop and he plays something with Divine Shield, I'd be super sad. Oh, Flame Lance kills that, but the other one wouldn't be killed. 8, right? I guess he could Fire Blast the thing also. Uh-oh. Is this the end for me? I can't afford to Blessing Wisdom that 3-3. Need to draw a card. And he could easily make me not draw a card.
Yeah.
Not enough.
For justice.
Like, maybe it's a good answer on this turn, but in the long term, it wouldn't be good enough. Well, that's justice. It hit four guys. Prediction correct. I don't think I'm gonna be able to hit eight guys, though. Probably not. Oh, man. Wow! That's pretty good. That wasn't that good. It was decent. It looked better than it. It was better than... I don't know how to say it.
Someday I'll be just like you.
It was decent. Do I have any heals in this deck? I do have that, definitely have funnel kicks. Okay, so I have attacks. I have the board control. If I draw funnel kicks, he doesn't have any direct damage. They'll win this thing. And True Silver too. Oh, okay.
Well played.
Yeah, 8 wins. All right, I'll take it. Alright, well, thanks for watching. That actually makes the third time in a row where my prediction was either correct or...